you're in the studio with the live local artist tonight. I'm somewhere on the side of the highway off of 820 out in Fort Worth, Azle, Lake Worth area. That's where I'm at. And the fog, what can I say? It's running errands. And
so beautiful.
It is absolutely beautiful. Francine talked to me and she actually challenged me into making this painting. So here I am. I'm gonna make a foggy painting for you tonight. And the approach is, I don't know. It's painting the fog, capturing the scene. It's not going to be an easy trick, so it's going to be quite challenging. What
I
am I going to do?
Van Gogh bright colors. I want thick,
it was the colors that were
gloppy,
shining out that
shiny,
made us pull over.
Neon, glowy.
So here I am to try. I'll tell you what my approach. Okay, so the canvas I have is like a 16x20 standard canvas. Nothing special. Okay. Except for the fact that it's on my easel. And now...
the lettuce is on.
How am I going to fit this whole scene? You see, look at the glowing light is what brought me in. I'm like a moth.
Yes, yes.
But also that shell sound, right? I got to bring that in somewhere in here.
So
I'm thinking
fit,
like right
you
in
get
here.
That in
but
there.
Then I got to, like, like compress the landscape into this.
You just got to move that in closer, yeah.
Yeah, that's not an easy feat.
Yeah.
Foot.
Okay.
Not an easy foot.
Not an easy foot. Okay, well, let's get started.
So
you got titanium white.
What I'm going to do, I've got titanium white, some red, blue, brown,
you got the
green,
reds and the browns,
I got
the purples,
browns.
And yellows.
Okay, but I also have
one
another palette here because these are going to be like highlights. But what I'm going to begin with is just like a soup.
Okay.
The soup of this.
Where you have to slosh it on, I guess.
So I'm squeezing out a lot of titanium white. I see a lot of titanium white in there. And look at that. I've got a 2.5-inch angle sash brush. First, I'm going to pour some painting medium. It's Grumbacher, Galfield, or something like that. Pouring that out. Getting it on my palette. I see blue, and I see brown, and I see red. I see greens, but I see a lot of browns, so I'm skipping up my browns. Where's my brown at? It's kind of tough to see the colors at this, with
I
this
think
lighting.
That's brown right
no,
there.
No, that's not brown. I think this one here is brown. We're going to...
I bet it's purple.
No, I didn't put purple down.
Oh, okay.
I got some brown.
Okay,
yeah, that's brown. Yay.
Down. Yay, you got
good, brown. Are we going to mix
good
that with some white?
Good old-fashioned brown color.
Okay, now I'm gonna push my brown all the way over to the side. That's gonna get everywhere. So I'm working with a brown brush tonight. I might have just really
browned it up
too much, but we're gonna introduce some. This is French Ultramarine over here. I'm taking a big scoop of that. Put it down right there. Find a place. Oh, I'll just
hold
it.
I don't have a ring light, guys.
Okay, it's all right. No ring light. You might be able to turn on a flash or something like that there. I'm gonna just mix up some blue into that. Oh, look,
oh,
at,
look
that.
At that. Oh, oh my goodness.
Wow.
You guys can see. This is the color now.
Okay.
That's
so
like a
here I'm doing
brown.
This.
Wow.
Okay. So this is going to be...
this is a highly technical drawing that we have to do here. And technical in that your movements have to be swift and precise. You got to know what you're doing.
I thought the best approach is going to be with a kind of like a... outstretch. If you can see, I'm backed up away from my easel.
It's
I,
like he's sword fighting.
Like I'm sword fighting. Rapier, if you will. Right?
Yeah.
I'm
I think.
Flashing.
Yeah.
The horizon line is low. I want to capture that low horizon line, but yet capture that up there. Right? So. Dip my brush in the mineral spirits. I'm scooping up a big glob of yellow.
Scooping up some big globs of yellow there.
Scooping up the big, and I'm going to put that in the
translator.
putting that on the outside here, all around the outside, keeping that away from the just light bouncing off of everything coming across. And now,
what color are you?
You're a dark blue.
Okay. Straight out with a tube of paint. Sorry for the technical difficulties. Well, let me zoom back out, finally.
I'm coming in with some yellow now. I'm just starting to highlight. I'm flowing. I'm sorry I'm not talking to you much. I'm just flowing over here.
Yeah.
Getting this paint going.
I can be the translator.
You're the translator.
Okay, so caking on some yellow. I'm gonna capture these lights. I want them thick, 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 thick. I think it'll look good. I love the way the neon lights, all the lights seem to come to life just a little bit more. They are glowing in the night with the mist all around them. It's a very favorable photography condition. Christmas present.
We're testing out the Cezanne tonight.
Yeah, it's
a Cezanne test.
It kind of has been given way in the knees a little bit.
Yeah, it gave way in the knees tonight.
But more so tonight.
When I needed it most.
You're not holding up Cezanne.
Yeah, Cezanne.
You need some reinforcement in those feet.
Christmas gift, Santa Claus. Okay, I got some purple on my brush now, and I'm using the purple for like the deep, deep, dark.
Deep shadows for the purple. Okay.
You know what ends up happening when once the brush hits the canvas and the paint starts to flow, you gotta just let go of whatever you thought you had in mind.
Right.
And capture the balance on the in the composition. And then you can come back and start to tweak out the and draw and use your capacity. But first you have to find the natural balance. And you just have to let your instinct take control.
Right.
And even though my original composition, you know, calls for a much larger canvas, I had high hopes. And I've had to adjust my drawing to I still have some illustrating techniques that I can incorporate that make the give the illusion of this landscape working out in a real
how it really is.
Yeah, well, if I wanted to be real analytical about the drawing perspective and whatever, I could pick it apart. It's like my ugly cups. If you
right.
know my pottery, you know my cups, I mark them with the ugly. They're ugly cups. Right. Just check them out. Ugly cup. If you don't know what I'm talking about, get schooled. They're the cups I make, the pottery. And they're not perfect. But somehow that.
But everything tastes perfect. Better in them.
But everything tastes better in them.
And it's like a real mug. A real cup.
So I'm bringing out some dark blue. It's probably Prussian blue. I really couldn't see what it was I was pulling out. Now, I really like the way that the fog occurs in sheets. It looks like curtains.
Being drawn. Tiny, like very thin veils of curtain being drawn.
Yeah. So in case you're wondering, yeah, that's the price of the gas over here. Just in case you're wondering. Is it Shell? Okay. But we're over here off of 820, so
it
won't really benefit you if you're not in the area. But I love the way the lights look. Just beautiful. But check at that neon glow. There's this old photograph at... Well, I believe it was Amon Carter, could have been the modern, but they would rotate it out, and it was a cyanotype or a Kodachrome. I'm sorry, a Kodachrome. They both start with a C. Okay. No, actually, Kodachrome. but the it was like a Shell station, and that those colors were so vibrant in my mind. I loved them. I fell in love with that photograph. I don't remember who the artist was, but the photographer. It's like the fog enveloping everything. It's like that movie, The Stuff.
The Stuff? I was thinking The Fog.
Okay, yeah, The Fog, okay. Except for that was, they were both horror movies. Okay, I give it that. All right, never mind.
I gotta admit, I never stayed awake through The Fog, so I don't even know.
I couldn't fall asleep afterwards. I don't know if I watched the whole thing, but I just couldn't take it.
Was it bad? Was it horrible?
Well,
obviously not worth worrying about. I didn't worry about it. I was living in Texas. We don't get much fog. It's gone by the time the sun comes up.
Yeah. Oh, and fog during the day, it's so beautiful. I know it's the toughest to drive in and all. I know it's not favorable driving conditions, but it's beautiful.
I'm just working with the dark colors right now, layering in what I feel like I see there in the depth. Before, I haven't even painted the fog yet. I'm painting everything. I'll paint the fog. The fog has to be treated in itself. It has to be treated as a layer.
After this is dry.
As an element. It's its own
element of nature.
And it comes in after the fact.
So I'm just trying it.
It's like a cover. It's like a blanket.
It's finished.
Huh?
I just mixed some green in with some blue and some blue over here. Okay. We're gonna see what we get. I'm trying to cut in this area down here.
Excuse me. Sure wish I had my gimbal tonight. Usually have an extra piece of recording equipment on me.
You better be ready.
I know.
The driver was ready to go home. You were like, I bet you won't make a painting in the fog.
I showed you.
I'll challenge you. I know. Now I'm like, now I'm freezing. I got to go to the bathroom and I'm shaking and I'm not holding the camera so steady, but you know what? I'm like, I'm here. I'm sticking to it. I'm not giving in. I'm even holding your canvas down for you.
Well, I'm getting close to your finger.
I know. It's all right. It's wipeable. But I'm loving these colors. They look really good. It's really looking good as an abstract painting.
You know, kind of abstract. I'm leaving it that way.
But, I'm seeing the Shell station sign now. Yeah, I know. Oh, no, I'm starting to see. Yeah, I'm starting to see some more of it. Looking good.
Hey, so look for me Monday around 2 o'clock at the side of the old Leaning Tower. I'm supposed to be interviewing somebody or being interviewed. I don't know, somebody's making a science channel show or something. Maybe I shouldn't talk about it.
He's just excited. He doesn't know what he's saying. Go back to bed. Here's his recall. Anybody know what that movie clip is from? Yeah. Sorry I didn't cut you off for sooner. Anyway, just go back to painting thunderstorms. Does anybody know that movie? Anyway. Yeah, but I am trying to put together some little video clips of Leaning Tower art. I have been working on that in the background.
And you should find the one of me where, like, the wind had just blown everything over.
I think I do have that.
I just remembered that.
Yeah, the constant
Oh my God.
Challenge day. How many times can you pick up your easel?
How many times can I pick up my easel in a day?
Yeah, that was fun. I'll keep holding
it for
you.
I wouldn't have gone had my brother not called me and told me, hey, you need to go out there.
Thanks, Jimmy Joe.
Thanks, Jimmy.
And you know what? Conveniently, you had no work lined up like for 2 weeks. It's like nothing. It was like nothing was coming up.
There were a lot of people waiting on me.
Oh, okay. I just didn't know about them.
You at home and the kids.
Right. We're always seeing you. That's almost like looking like a boat going in the water at this close-up angle that I'm photographing it. Almost.
Oh, you know. You're making me self-conscious, Francine.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'll stop yapping. But here's where we're at. Hi, Ryan. Thanks for watching. Hello, Hearn. Thanks for watching. So we're trying to document the beautiful fog, the lights, how they glow, you know, the beauty of this.
You actually helped me to refocus what I needed to be focusing.
You started painting something different after I started saying what we were doing.
Well, I needed to back up and look at my painting.
Oh, yeah.
You know, you got to do that periodically.
And get a cup of coffee.
It had been a while since I stepped back to look at the way lines are flowing. When you get up in there and you start losing all sense of time and all that.
Yeah.
See, it's a nice drawing, but I don't feel foggy.
Well, like you said, the layer, it's not bad from it. I mean, it's different, but I thought you have to reapply something after you do let it dry a bit.
Yeah, I see.
I think you've got to give a little bit of time. I don't know, but you know.
Look at this. Let's look at the lights there.
Thank
see
you.
That white all around there.
That glow.
Yeah, the glow. The what? Here's that. I don't have. Now, if you look at I don't have this intersecting lines that come in through here and drive the focal point down and in. And then there's rows of bright white that I need to capture up in here. And then this on the horizon over here, this needs to occur. Something that glowing halos down at the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
All right, you ready? Here we go.
How do you suppose you're going to do that? Challenge number 85,000.
White, yellow. Okay, let's see. We are going to first drop this.
Thank you. Hearn from Thailand says she loves our paintings.
Thank you.
Hi, Martha. Thanks for joining. Whoops. Hi. Oops. Sorry about that. Now you see me, the camera girl. That's why I'm behind the camera. And so, if you're just tuning in, this is what we're trying to capture in this beautiful, foggy weather. And Jerrel is meeting the challenge of making the underside of this extremely bright and white, and trying to capture the mist. You can really see that. You can see that mist. It's really beautiful. So, that looks really, really good. It's getting there. Step back and watch a little bit further. Something wrong. Okay, here we go. Back on. There we go. Technical difficulty. Excellent. Push the button with my finger. Gotta clean those brushes. What is that? So yellow. I was gonna just slosh that on. Now he's gonna paint something. You missing a paintbrush or something? Oh, the palette knife. Okay. Or a type of palette knife. Oh, well, I can't dance and hold the camera. It's gonna be too wavy.
I'll dance.
Okay.
Everybody wants her, cause she's a star. Everybody loves her, she's so bizarre. Everybody's looking at her, everybody's running for her. Everybody wants her body, but her body's no body.
I know you just can't believe. You can't take your eyes off me.
What about Jolene? Oh, that's good. Thanks for moving. So sorry. Oh. Let's hit pause. Sorry. Is this John Bloomquist? Huh? Oh, it's Green Velvet. Green Velvet.
Thank you.
watching the live local artist Jerrel Sustaita. Tonight, we're trying to capture the foggy night.
Yeah, it's pretty foggy out this evening. We were out running errands and we noticed how the light was being refracted through all the tiny particles in the atmosphere, and I just wanted to capture. Francine didn't think I would actually step up, but here I am. And it's proven to be quite a task to do, to capture the feeling of all the moisture in the air. It's easy enough. It's hard enough to come out, actually. It's hard enough to set up and make a painting at night. But now with such atmosphere, how could I resist? Right now I'm going to start attempting to make everything feel like it's shrouded in mist. If you can see, everything is bright and vibrant. We've got a little...
There's a flash on it.
There's a flash on the angle of the night.
Yeah, it's like
it's a little abstract.
It's a little Renoir.
So I mix up a color and then I find where is it happening in the environment, and that's when I. Never to send it.
Give the shakiness. I forgot my gimbal.
This is some kind of pinkish orange that I felt like needed to be added in here.
Yeah.
Take that all the way across the horizon and cut into some of this occupied yellow over here. It's picking up some of that phthalo blue. Forget about the power lines. We'll redraw them. I was trying to abide by the lines that they had created for themselves early on, but they weren't working. It was time to let them go. Time to let them go. Now, I need to make a gradient of this sky here, so I'm going to get some more of this dark blue, and I'm going to put it right down on that line. There's something happening here, right along this line. And I just did that number to it. Bring that down all the way. Bring that land, that horizon line down even further. And just bend the horizon, the landscape over here. But it all fits in the somehow in that perspective that I'm creating. It has a fisheye kind of feel to it. And I'm hacking up the atmosphere. Step back, look at the work.
Are you gonna come back with like very defined lines?
Well, I should at least come back with some yellow. I feel like I need some more yellow in there.
The white lines?
Definitely some white.
Between all the cars and
yeah,
the pumps?
And draw out the pumps. I've got to draw the pumps.
Yep.
Pumps. And then maybe a little bit more around that, the Shell logo.
Yeah. I'll detail that just a little bit.
Yeah, definitely can add a little bit more oomph to it. Look at my finger.
Yeah, it's all blue.
Got that color on there.
The color of the night sky. The flash could be doing it a disservice. No, it's still much darker. It looks like a hot dog.
Looks like a hot dog?
It looks like a hot dog off the grill that got charred. Okay, so you want to take
like
a break?
A hot dog.
Oh, gross. All right, you want to take a break and come back?
I'm going to take a break and I'll come back.
Okay. All right, thanks for tuning in.
We'll see you later.